let me just give you two statistics. In our Congress, in the 70s, about 40% in Congress considered themselves moderate. 30% then liberal, 30% conservative. Today, it's 10% moderate, 90% one side or the other. Citizens in this country today, if you go back to the 70s, about 29% of people self-identified as ideologically extreme in the 70s. Today, it's nearly 50%. But if you actually go in and look at, so people think of themselves as more radical or ideologically extreme. But if you actually go in and measure their opinions on when life begins or whatever, there's been a subtle shift, maybe 5 to 10%. Something has happened to cause us to exaggerate our differences, use your term, to join tribes, and then engage in warfare with the other side. And the question is, why have we somehow, with slight shifts in differences, become so vicious and polarized toward others? And I believe there are several reasons for that, but I believe one is that ideology has become the new religion. The amount of fervor that we have today around ideology often used to be reserved for the most extremes in religion. And the second thing that I think has happened is social media has given us a way to amplify and make our voices larger and to attract more of the radical people. So as a result of that, what's happened in the area of values and in ideology, we have accelerated our ability to wound each other. We've expanded it greatly, but we've done nothing to improve our ability to reconcile or heal each other. What I see in a lot of the most vicious discourse are wounded people doing battle with other wounded people on the other side. So I think there are forces in our society today that have caused value differences to be much more destructive than they were even 30, 40 years ago. We've always had differences, but something different's going on today.
Yeah. Is there a set of solutions? What can that person watching this program do personally to help move things out of this place where we are right now?
In the business world, what I see is a significant move toward CEOs and C-suite executives and all the way down the organization for greater collaboration and working together. So in the corporate world right now, if you look at what's kind of the trend, it is trying to do more of that. In larger society, we don't see much evidence for that. And the point that I make in the most recent article on radicalization of relationships is today the extremes are running the country and running the world. So the passion, all of the energy, all the juice is coming from the extreme left or extreme right. And so the number of people who are none of the above, neither Democrat or Republican, has doubled in the last 50 years. What's happened is the extremes are running parties and so forth, and this group that's really pretty dissatisfied with things are on the sideline. They're in the kind of the default. They define their relationship by the relationship they don't have. I'm not Democrat, I'm not Republican, I'm none of the above. I think what's going to have to happen is we're going to have what I call the relationals emerge, and that are people who look at this situation and saying, we've got to go from passive, I'm none of the above, to I'm in favor of strong collaborative relationships where people work together and they sometimes find a third way. So the group that's in the middle, that's silent and passive, is going to have to get organized, and they may have to do that outside of Democrat or Republican. Some group has to emerge, because it's interesting, even if they have maybe 40% of today's society, the 30% extreme on each side is controlling who winds up in general elections and so forth. So my takeaway is, if you are really concerned about the level of animus that's going on in polarization today, there has to be a third group emerge that is an advocate for a movement, and they are actively involved in a more collaborative, more some of the founding of this country, more democratic approach. We may have to have more pain before we get to the gain, to get to a new paradigm that explains what will have greater gain and explain more what's going to happen. I think that's the new relationals. I hope we're close to that.